Hey, who doesn't like a cold beer every now and then? Everyone has their favorites, from ales to stouts, from lager to porters. And we like ours with a crab cake. Today on This Crab Cake, we're joined by some of the beer gurus, or as we call them, brew-yous, from Katcef Brothers. And we're going to talk, you guessed it, beer.
We're here at Katcef Brothers again in advance of Valentine's Day and in advance of St. Patrick's Day, which is getting really, really close, and I'm excited about it. And we're joined again by Lauren Hamilton, Bill Catron. We've got Cassie Mabry over here on my right. How are you guys today?
Fantastic.
Wonderful.
Bill? What? How's Bill?
Really? Bill's fantastic.
There we go.
I got to say that I watched the Super Bowl, didn't see a darn Clydesdale once. Kind of neat. But it had the Bud Light Seltzer, which was...
The Post Malone.
And we turned around and we drank it last week. No, last month.
Last month, yeah.
And it was good.
It's really good.
The commercial was really good.
Commercial's great. People seem to really like the commercial.
So, but yeah, that was a surprise. I don't know how many years it's been that they haven't had Clydesdales, but it's...
Usually when they don't have the Clydesdales, the people revolt and get very upset when they don't get their Clydesdale fix in the commercials every year. But I think this one, with the being the true American, I think that
spoke
to people in a way that the Clydesdales kind of do, you know? It's very
And everybody's probably all ticked off about Shakira and J-Lo anyway.
Everyone was so angry at that point that, you know...
I don't know if everybody was distracted. Angry.
Well, yeah, it's either you were completely entertained or incredibly angry, and it depends on which level of Facebook mom
they are. They are very talented.
They are extremely talented.
Indeed.
It's been very entertaining.
I thought it was great. I enjoyed it.
I mean, you know, they're older.
43 and what, 50?
And they look fantastic. I mean, they look like they work out. And I can't do what they do, right? At all.
Thank God for small favors.
Well, yeah. Seriously.
Yeah.
That's an image none of us needed today.
Okay. Hold on.
Can we steer Bill back to the horses?
I would not approve of this is, this,
they didn't have the Dalmatian either.
Well, this is Valentine's
they didn't
Day.
Have the horses.
We're talking about love.
We're talking about love, which means love. Bill in a glittery onesie on a Super Bowl stage.
Ladies, don't listen to any of that.
Well, that just took a dark turn.
I could have made that darker, but I chose not to.
Thank you.
That says something. If you were going to make something darker,
I'm almost as tempted to call her bluff on it and see.
I know. Right?
See where it can go.
Go ahead, Cassie. Give us your best shot.
So Valentine's Day is on Friday.
It is. What are you guys doing? Anything? Well, you introduced me to the word Galentine's Day last year,
and I had never
heard of that, and it popped up a couple times this year. So
Galentine's Day is a thing. Thank you, Leslie Knope.
So what are you guys up to? Anything?
Womp, womp. Amber Room shenanigans.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe a Stella Artois.
That's a great question. What trying to make my wife happy. I guess that's about it.
The never-ending conquest.
Yeah, there's never-ending conquest.
That ain't for Valentine's Day, dude.
When you look
Disney
like...
on Ice for me.
You're going to Disney on Ice?
We are.
Oh, goodness.
Baltimore or D.C.?
D.C.
That's awesome. Children.
Much better.
What has Stella got going? I mean, you mentioned Stella Artois. What do they got going for Valentine's Day?
So this Valentine's Day, share the love with Stella. So Stella is always been a Valentine's Day beer for us. That's been something we've done for years and years and years. It's an easy pairing. But this year they have partnered with Lindt chocolates. So you can get your Stella and your chocolate. Yeah. So you can get your Stella and your chocolate. There's some mail-in rebates, some instant gratification. Mail-in rebates, scan them with your phone, take a picture of your receipt, and get some money back on your Stella and Lindt chocolate purchases. So take a peek around your local liquor store when you go out shopping and see what's there.
Bill, I think that might make your wife happy.
Get her a coupon. That will work.
Full disclosure.
Get her a coupon before you buy that truck you were just talking about. Yeah, well,
got the truck, but full disclosure, my wife is, so I'm on a diet for you ladies out there.
That's the glittery onesie.
My wife said to me, she goes, I can't be bigger than you. So she's not doing chocolate.
Oh, look at what you've done. Oh. Look at the joy that you've sucked out
I don't
of her
do
life.
It. Yes, I have actually. All the french fries, Jesus Christ. I love french fries.
Mm. You should treat yourself.
I can't.
They probably make cauliflower french fries.
Oh,
out there.
That's a blend. No. No. I want the crinkle cut. I want them fried nicely with salt. Okay. And Heinz 57.
He's getting cranky.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. I'm hangry.
Look how wistful he looks, though, right now as he talks about the exact ketchup that he wants.
Yeah.
The french fries.
He just ate a whole bowl of oranges. It was like eight in there.
Well, I mean, a man's got to keep, you know, his sugar levels up. I mean, you know, but. I'm just saying. It's
vitamin
like
C, it's flu season.
Yeah, it's flu. Anybody have the Kong flu's out there, you know? So we got that going on. We can't catch that. What was that? Coronavirus?
Coronavirus.
I call it the Kong flu.
That's definitely not politically correct. I mean, it is what it is. Anyway, you might have to
call that. Stella and Lindt chocolate.
You know what else keeps the flu away? Alcohol. So let's talk more about that. Yeah, so Stella and Lindt chocolates. And then that will be kind of the last of our traditional Stella stuff for the spring, because we are about to launch all the new fun things with Stella.
What are they doing? What's new and fun?
A pony.
Or is it?
It is a pony. Well, it's not like a real pony. I wish it were a real pony. That would really combine my two worlds. But it is a pony bottle. It is the Stella Artois Petite. So it is a 7-ounce Stella bottle that'll be sold in 6-packs coming the end of March.
Oh, nice.
Yes, okay. So it's a really nice option for, like, you know, some people try not to drink during the week and kind of have that better for you mentality. I know I'm trying to do it. I know we've all tried to. Bill's probably the best at it, hence the diet. But, you know, during the week, a lot of times you don't want a full beer or two full beers, but you want to have something nice with dinner. So the 7-ounce bottle is perfect for that. We've done 8-ounce cans of Michelob Ultra in the past. Those were really successful. So we'll have a 7-ounce bottle of Stella year-round starting the end of March.
Well, everything is going that way. I mean, I know the Cokes and Pepsis are going with the little tiny cans as well.
Smaller serving. If you're going to make that choice, you might as well do it in a way that's a little bit better for you. Yeah.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah, it's a cool play. I think it's going to be a big success. And then we will have a summer seasonal from Stella this year called Solstice. That will be here right before Memorial Day. This is the first time they're doing a summer seasonal. So, again, something new. And then already airing, but technically launching here in the next week or so, is the new Stella program, which is the Life Artois, which is celebrating all of the things in life that people appreciate and how you can do that with a Stella. So you've probably seen the commercials. There's some new really kind of artsy kind of Euro style commercials that are playing, and there'll be some more coming across social media and things like that.
Cool.
Euro style. That's a great explanation.
Yeah. So getting away from that kind of stuffy kind of, you know, boutique-y feel and applying it to how Stella applies to your everyday life, how that enjoying that moment.
It's all about mixing things up. I mean, you know, Bud Light's making seltzers now.
Bud Light's making seltzers now, and Post Malone is picking them. So we are mixing it up.
Well, I mean, and you also had that that Babe last summer. Was it last summer or 2 summers ago that it was introduced?
2 summers ago now.
Wow.
That's crazy. Yeah, 2 summers ago now, we introduced Babe. And Babe, again, Valentine's Day, it's a great drinking occasion. It's a great wine occasion. Why not do it in a can?
Pick up a 4-pack, Babe Rosé.
Yeah.
Add a straw to it.
Or the red.
I'm in.
Red wine on Valentine's Day. Pinot Grigio. You can't, no way to do it wrong. Can't lose.
Fantastic. After Valentine's Day, not too far, because Annapolis does things very weirdly. We've got St. Patrick's Day on the 7th and 8th of March. Even though St. Patrick's Day really is the 17th, but we kind of do it a week earlier. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, for some reason Annapolis does. We've been doing it that way for years now.
You know, John O'Leary, who does the parade, told me the reason that he did it, and this makes all the sense in the world to me, was that the businesses don't need any help on St. Patrick's Day. People are going to come out, and they're going to eat, and they're going to drink, and they're going to have their corned beef, and they're going to have a good time. They need help in the winter, because we're basically a tourist town. So you come in a week earlier, give the businesses a boost, but also he can attract more people to come to the parade, because they're not going to D.C. or Baltimore or Philadelphia or maybe even New York. So that means units in the parade as well as people to watch it. So that's why that parade showed up a week earlier. And it's sort of stuck, and it's just sort of like one of those weird things of Annapolis, I guess.
It works, though.
And it doesn't compete with Baltimore either. So Baltimore folks can come down and enjoy our festivities.
You guys are having the 6th annual Shamrock Stroll, which is the Irish version of a pub crawl.
6 years of green. And our bagpipers.
Which is fantastic. It's $5 to join, right?
And
$5. You get a custom commemorative koozie, and you can register up at the second floor of Armadillo starting at noon on Saturday the 7th.
Yep. Features along the way.
Armadillo's and Dock Street, Middleton's and McGarvey's. And I'm noticing an alliteration there right down there. You know, Dillo's and Dock Street, Middleton's and McGarvey's. Harvest, Acme, Ram's Head, Stan and Joe's, and ultimately stumbling in and finishing up at Fido. And I've got to mention the Australian fundraiser.
Oh, yeah.
What a...
It was unbelievable.
you know, did the city come out and support that or what?
Did they come? They came and they raised $14,000.
That's insane. That's so awesome.
Silent auctions, raffles,
yeah.
Live auction. The mayor was auctioned off for $700.
We haven't seen him since.
That's impressive.
Well, unfortunately, we haven't, but he's I believe he was en route on the 11th.
Yeah.
So I'll be excited to give him a big hug.
But no, that was fantastic. And I mean, a lot of money was raised there. There was a varmint that the mayor arranged to bring in.
Her name was Savannah, and she was a Joey. Cool. Ruse for you, Germantown.
And no, but just, you know, thank you to the city of Annapolis and everybody that came out for that. That was just such a great effort. It shows... there is some humanitarianism left in the world, so that's always a good thing. We could use a little bit more of that. But that was a great host for that. They were they're always good. Dublin Five was there. There were a couple other bands I know that were there as well, and it was just a good time for everybody. What's happening with Bud Light Seltzer though? I mean, is it still
it's moving.
It is still the hot ticket.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's huge. Yeah. It's crazy. We can't keep it in stock. No one can. It's crazy.
Okay, but so it's like the Old Bay hot sauce.
Yeah, kind of. yeah, a little bit. It's it's on fire. It's absolutely on fire.
More so than the Natterdays, or in
yes.
a different way.
Yes, in a different way. I think this one has it has a broader scope than Natterdays. Natterdays, as delicious as it is a little bit more polarizing. Seltzer is, as a category, is on fire. So the scope that this product reaches is huge, and I mean, I'm seeing it everywhere. People absolutely love it. Feedback has been amazing. The flavors are fantastic. You know, we tried them last month. So yeah, Bud Light Seltzer is on fire. I can't wait to see what it does this summer.
Well, and the one thing I do remember from last month was the flavoring. I mean, it didn't have that alcohol-y aftertaste mm-hmm. to me for some reason. I mean, it was a very well blended.
Yeah, they nailed it. You know, drinks really easy. They absolutely nailed the flavors.
Dangerously easy.
Dangerously easy.
Dangerously easy, I might
Drink
add.
Drink responsibly.
I might add. But St. Patrick's Day is just a great time in Annapolis. It really sort of kicks off the spring, which obviously is a precursor into summer, which is coming there. So we're looking forward to that.
Also the parade on March 8th. So yep. The big St. Patrick's Day parade downtown Annapolis, followed by Shamrock the Duck, second year.
Oh, that's right. I forgot you guys did that. We did that last year. Well, the parade kicks off at 1 o'clock up sort of Maryland Hall-ish area. Goes the typical parade route down West Street, around the circle, and down Main Street, and ramps up down at City Dock. There will be a stage down there. There will be some bands that will be playing for Shamrock the Dock.
Some Bud Light Seltzers.
they've got the liquor licenses all set to be able to sell alcohol down on City Dock there as well. And all of the bars, you know, will be rocking as well. So there'll be a, you know, if you're looking for a fun time on Sunday, you know, maybe call out sick on the 9th. That might not be a bad idea. You know, I mean, hey, a lot of people do on the 18th. So
it's just planning ahead.
Yeah,
we're just planning ahead.
Well, there's that push to get the day after the Super Bowl made a holiday.
That should definitely happen.
It really needs to happen.
I think any president that does that is instant re-election. Any president.
Throw your hat in the ring, Bill.
They don't want me as president, believe me.
Yeah, trust me, none of us want that. We all love Bill, but none of us want that.
Yeah. I love you too.
Oh, see, it's all in the spirit of Valentine's Day, guys.
Yeah.
Share the love.
Share the love.
So what else is new in beer world?
That's a great question. So we're going out of the winter seasonals into the spring seasonals.
Thank gosh. Those are all those dark beers that I can't see.
That's true. We'll have to have some summer seasonals and spring seasonals for you next month.
Yeah, and I see less is more. One of the trends that I see is that a lot of breweries are putting out three or four brands instead of one, and they're putting out like a kind of like hyper, like it's kind of like a broad spectrum, right? So you're going to have the really high-end stuff, you're going to have middle tier, and then you're going to have kind of like the lower stuff. So that way you hit a spectrum of different price points. So when people buy these things, they have a different breadth to look at, right? So I see a lot of brands flooding the market like that. From a lot of breweries, but a lot of different styles too. I think sours are making more of a comeback this year. I didn't see a lot of sours last year compared to what I'm seeing this year.
Session sours especially.
Session sours. I mean, New England sours I'm seeing.
Yeah. Or sour IPAs.
Yeah. Yeah. And sour New England IPAs. I'm seeing pomegranate sours, which I'm sure are delicious, but man, you're starting with a sour pace and then going real sour. So it's like, you know, there's a lot going on there.
You know? I got turned on to sours 4 years ago, and I had never had one, and it was at a bar in Philadelphia, and I said, that sounds sort of interesting and whatnot. And I didn't know what to expect. And I took it. And I was like, whoa, it was just, you know, really, really bit into you as sour. Mm-hmm. And then once my mouth got used to it, it's like, you know, this isn't bad. I mean, it was, the initial thing was something that I just wasn't expecting. I know it's like, you know, grabbing a glass of wine and realizing it's scotch.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
it's like just grabbing your first IPA.
Yeah,
you expect
yeah.
that hot bomb, and then you get it, but then your palate adjusts yeah. to it, and then you're like, oh, I kind of like it's, this. Same thing.
But that's interesting that the sours are coming back.
Well, the sours are interesting because they're brewed like a normal beer, right? Because they are a beer, but the thing is they drink like a cider. So they drink like a 4% cider. So I've had sours that are like 9.5% alcohol. They drink like a 4%. So I think people like that aspect because they're watery to a not watery, but like they have that viscosity where they're not very heavy.
Right.
So you have that. And then, so the one thing that makes them sour is how you kettle sour them, right? So you have different yeast strains. You have lactobacillus, you have bruxellensis, you have all types of different yeast strains. They eat the sugar at different rates. Therefore it creates different flavor profiles. And there you go.
Two words that I've never heard in my life again. Those two bacteria words. Yeah. You just rolled off the end of your tongue there. That's like amazing to me. Diving deep into the vats of beer.
Yeah. The vats of Bill's knowledge.
You amaze me, sir. I've retold the story about Oktoberfest and the wedding and whatnot. And people look at me like, wow, man, you like know your stuff. I'm like, yeah, no, I don't. I just listened that one day when Bill was telling me.
We make all our new sales reps spend at least one day with Bill because they get all of those like really great, like little anecdotes and really great stories that they can then do the exact same thing.
Which are absolutely perfect for a sales guy to come out there, throw that little tidbit out.
And like, all right, you're going to go learn lots of words you've never heard before with Bill. And this is how you use them. Just do what he does.
And I pick every one of them up like the van in Old School.
That's
exactly how.
With pantyhose over his head, right, just right. Tagging him in the sidewalk.
Exactly. Exactly.
Oh. Well, I'll tell you, this is a good time of the year. I mean, we're getting out. I would say we're getting out of winter, but we haven't had a winter, which is kind of a. And I think we're not going to get one.
I don't either.
I don't think we're going to get snow. Just think if all of this rain had been snow.
You know what's worrisome about that, in my opinion? DC. We have more mosquitoes than anyone,
God.
And there was nothing to kill them off.
You know, it's the state bird.
Actually, I went to my vet, I'm going to digress for 2 seconds, and she goes,
we never do that.
She goes, does your dog take heartworm medicine? I'm like, well, you know, they're inside dogs. And she goes, no, they're doing it this year. She goes, the mosquito population is going to be out of control. And I was like, I started thinking about it, and I was like, oh, my gosh, she's right. So it's going to be really, really bad this year.
Makes all the sense in the world. But I want snow.
I do, too. I'm tired of mud.
Yeah, I want like a 2 foot or a 3 foot snow and just shut it all down for a couple days. Then we can call winter over and move on.
Just
well, remember a couple years ago during the Shamrock Stroll, it snowed.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and it was actually 10 years ago, probably about this time that we had those big back-to-back blizzards. That was a lot of fun.
That came up on my like Facebook memories or something, or somebody's Facebook memories. It came up on their like my feed that they had shared it, and it was a friend of mine that lives in a first floor apartment in Frederick, and the snowdrifts were up past her windows. And I was like, I couldn't
That's
even tell you so what that
cool.
kind of snow looks like anymore. It's been so long since we've had one like that.
But I am excited for this. Is really kind of wrapping up winter. We're kind of getting out of the days are getting longer, a little bit brighter. Sun shines out a little bit more often, and got Valentine's Day coming up in a couple of days. And certainly I'm looking forward to St. Patrick's Day and all the festivities that surround it starting on the 7th and the 8th. And that's really sort of the kickoff to spring. I mean, before you know it, the festivals will kick in up at the fairgrounds and First Sunday Arts will be going on again and everything else. So it'll be...
People will open up their patios, get some good patio drinking.
So will the mosquitoes in D.C. if you're
sitting
outside.
Mosquitoes may be taking your table.
You're scaring me with that mosquito stuff.
Just saying.
Make your plans. Valentine's Day. Get some of the Stella. Look for the scannable codes.
For the MIR with the Lindt chocolates. So
what's MIR?
Mail-in rebate.
Oh,
but
okay.
Now, because nobody actually mails anything in anymore, they're all on your phone.
Right.
But we still call them mail-in rebates or MIRs.
Right. And you want to look for the Stella ponies.
Yeah.
Are they calling them ponies?
No, they're calling them Petite Artois.
We're a little bit elevated.
We're not exactly talking about Rolling Rock, though I do love a good Rolling Rock pony. So it's going to be called Petite Artois, but it'll be in just the same packaging as regular Stella, so you won't be able to miss it.
I noticed the glasses on, or the glass bottle on that actually has like a not perforated, but it's like a, it says Petite Artois or whatever on it, and it's kind of bumped out from the glass.
Yeah.
And that's kind of
it's
a throwback.
It's like embossed.
Yeah, it's a throwback bottle,
embossed,
right?
Embossed. That's what it is.
I think it's like a 60s looking bottle, isn't it? It's like a 50s, 60s?
Yeah, kind of. It's the bottles that they got, Bill's right, they're absolutely gorgeous, but they do kind of have that like embossed kind of punch out on them. So it's just that really nice, elegant kind of, it's kind of a throwback feel, I guess.
Yeah, I think it's cool. It really is nice.
How long has Stella been around for?
Since, oh God, so Hoo Garden's 1445, Stella's 1333.
Stella,
yeah. Wow. And it was founded by a guy named Sebastian Artois. So that's where, actually before that, it was called the Den Horn Brewery. So if you look at the label of Stella, it'll have a horn on it. And they only made amber beer. So Sebastian Artois bought it. The records go back to 1333 because how they gauge brewery is they'll look at the malt bill, right? So whenever people paid taxes or bought something from somewhere, and that's where the bill of sale goes, and that's how they age the brewery.
Okay.
From the oldest point in time, right? So it goes back to 1333. I think Sebastian Artois bought it in 1600s. I think it was like 1694 or something like that. But he bought it. And that's when Stella Artois came in. And so he made the beer after the North Star, and that was literally the first Christmas beer. And that's when lagering first started coming out, and that's where all that beer came.
Perfect.
Yeah. See, he does it again.
and he doesn't have a book. He doesn't have his phone out. This was just right off the top of his head.
Yeah. I mean, it's not the looks.
I'm going to fact check this, man. It's going to be like the State of the Union, man. We're going to fact check 1333.
We could have a day of fact checking, Bill, and it would always check out. It's crazy. Yeah. We don't keep him around for as long.
Except ladies. It's not that bad.
Except ladies. He's quiet.
Well, enjoy Valentine's Day, everybody. Enjoy your Disney on Ice, Miss Mabry.
Yeah. Have fun with that.
And,
maybe try and get a Stella.
And I hope your wife enjoys her coupon.
Yeah, the chocolate.
Yeah.
That she won't eat.
Yeah. I'll just keep it on the table and just watch her, you know? Just what are you doing? Wait, what? You going to eat that, really? Oh. Kidding. Actually, it's a bad way to be out.
Well, till next month. And next month, we're really when we get into spring, which I'm really excited about.
We're going to bring you some spring beers. You're
going
to love them.
Yeah, we're going on like no beers today.
No beers today.
No, they're coming.
Well, we got to keep you guessing.
No seltzers. No. Yeah, I know. Well,
keep you guessing.
Yeah, also keeps me coming back.
That's true. Maybe this time they'll have beer for me. Maybe this time I'll get to crack the bottle right in the microphone again.
That's right. Anything else we missed?
No. Happy Valentine's.
We will see you here next month, and happy St. Patrick's Day.
This Crab Cake has been brought to you by the Maryland Crabs. Full episodes release every Thursday at noon. Please make sure you subscribe and visit us online at themarylandcrabs.com.